silver is way below its equilibrium price. From my analysis, the equilibrium price right now for silver is almost $16. And as the buying interest increases, that equilibrium price moves up. So the price, real price, actually tries to chase it. So from that point of view, silver is ready to move better and stronger than gold. It's just having a bit of a headwind right now. Once it overcomes that, I think we'll see silver outperform gold quite dramatically.
Now, in regards to that and the little hang-up that silver has right now, according to your analysis, do you think silver is going to look a lot better, as per your analysis, before gold breaks through 1,000, or might it continue to lag just a bit until we get that major breakout in gold?
I would say that it will probably start to outperform gold before gold goes through 1,000. I think this bit of headwind is only very short term. It may be over by the end of next week. So I don't see it being a major lag on silver for very long.
And just to reiterate, you're looking for a even more explosive move in silver once we get these breakouts in the entire sector.
Absolutely, in silver, you know, as you probably know, I mean, there's very little left on the planet. The U.S. Geological Society said just a couple of years ago that silver would be the first element in the periodic table that would become extinct, and that news almost got buried on probably page 20 of the Wall Street Journal. You know, that's incredibly bullish. They said that would happen by 2020. You know, if we're in the situation where we can run out of silver, the price clearly has to go up, because we can't obviously run out of silver. What will happen is the price will have to go to a price level where it's economic to recycle it. We recycle almost all the gold we use in any industrial application, but we throw silver away in our cell phone batteries and soldered connections, this sort of thing, in landfills. So the price has to go to a price probably close to the price of gold right now for it to be economic to not throw another gram of silver away in a landfill. We don't throw any gold away. So I see silver probably eventually reaching a price which is higher than gold, based on the fact that it's more rare than gold right now, because we've consumed it.
Oh, that's very interesting. You think that the silver-gold ratio then could presumably, I guess a historical average I think is 14 if I remember correctly. So you think that it could actually, in that case then it would go below 1?
Yeah, many analysts you know, keep the same sort of ratios that we had in the past, forgetting that we're consuming silver, and it's irretrievable. It's not going to ever be recycled from landfills. So the traditional ratio that you find in the Earth's crust is fine while there's still plenty of it around. But as it starts to become extinct, then silver becomes very rare and will become more rare than gold. It's difficult for us to get our minds around it right now, but that's what's going to happen. If you look what happened to rhodium, two years ago, it went from $300 to $10,000 an ounce. Most people probably don't even know that. It certainly didn't get on the front page of the Wall Street Journal. But you know, that was a move that could be made in a metal and didn't even make any news. You know, silver could do something that's a lot more dramatic.
Yeah, certainly. You know, we know that, you know, assuming gold makes this breakthrough 1,000, that it's likely to have quite a parabolic run. But everyone would agree that silver would probably do the same, and then it just becomes very difficult to know when it's going to end, when it's going to peak. And I would throw in that news tidbit you mentioned a few minutes ago from the geologic survey about silver extinction. That doesn't exactly sound like an extremely negative piece of fundamental news, I would say.
Right. And the you know, gold almost has no industrial applications. This is what the bears throw at us that is negative about gold, apparently, is that it has no use. Well, it has no use which consumes it. Its use, its sole use, essentially, is to store value. And that's what it does perfectly. And it obviously does it very well because we still have pretty much all the gold that's ever been mined in history, still above ground somewhere. So it's perfectly stored wealth for 6,000 years and has never been consumed. So this notion that there's something negative about gold because it has no industrial use is rubbish. It has one use, which is to store value, which is why governments hate it so much, because if gold is going up, there is only one reason why it's going up, and that's because people are using it to store value. Any other commodity which has more than one use, like silver, like copper, like oil, you can always point to, oh, it's the economy is recovering, that's why that commodity is going up. But gold you can't make excuses for, so that's why the price is suppressed. Silver does have industrial uses, and it competes with its use as a store of value. And the industrial use has been so big compared to investment demand that it's the industrial application which has suppressed the price. You imagine if you wanted to invest in bread, you wouldn't stand much chance of its price going up because people keep making as much bread as people ask for. And that's been the case with silver for a long time, except that it's drawn down most of the accumulated stocks. Now we're getting to the point where the investment demand and the industrial demand is in competition and will drive the price to very high levels. And we can't live without silver. At the limit, you could say, well, if gold disappeared from the planet tomorrow, life would still go on. If that was the case with silver, life would not go on. Most of the technology that we use today would just cease to exist.
Yes, well, I'm sure that, who knows, maybe in 5 years people will be selling and recycling their forks and their knives and spoons, given the economic situation and how high the price of silver might go. Now, I just want to get some final thoughts on the precious metals bull market. And I asked this to Bill Murphy during that interview. Now, some analysts I talk to, they see this being this run that we've presumably started. They see it lasting maybe 2 to 3 years in a huge spike. And Bill Murphy said he thinks it could go on for 5 to 8 years. Where do you fit in that camp? And also, do you think this bull market is going to end with some kind of a hard money standard or something else, namely really high interest rates?
Yes, I see it going on for a long time, mainly because this is not just a story about gold and silver. This is actually a story about the breakdown of the financial system, global financial system, the breakdown of currencies, and the breakdown of this scam that of fiat currencies. So that is what is making real things, commodities, and particularly gold and silver, to now increase in value with respect to those fiat currencies. And because that is systemic, this will last a long time, and it will last until there is a fix for that systemic problem. So, yes, what you mentioned there, the fix will eventually have to be some sort of hard money, some sort of backing of the currencies, and I can't see that happening for many years until politicians are really forced into that situation as a last resort. They'll try everything under the sun to avoid that before they go to a hard money system. So this will be a bull market that goes on a long time. As for interest rates, under the current structure, I can't see that can be a solution. If they were to raise interest rates like Volcker did to 21% to kill the commodity rallies, then we would do a lot of damage to the world economy. So I don't think that's a solution this time around. There's far too much leverage in the system compared to when Volcker did that, and the system just cannot take it.